Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. Tom Designs here, and in today's video, I will show you how I drew this Vespa scooter in Adobe Illustrator. By the way everyone, we're closing in on 100,000 subscribers, which is truly unbelievable, and I would like to thank you all for the support. If you're new to the channel, then please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel so we could get to our ultimate goal of 100k subscribers. Now let's get into this tutorial. So I started off by tracing a simplified sketch of my Vespa image I found on Google. Basically, I got rid of the details and keeping the main parts. The goal here is to draw a simple, minimal vector version of it in a cartoon style. I set up my sketch as a template with 50% opacity and started creating my layers one by one. Organizing my layers is always a priority of mine when drawing. I like to separate my vector drawings in three layers: the outline, the shadows, and the base layer. I then started to trace the drawing using the pen tool and some simple shapes. For this area, I used the Shape Builder tool. I selected the shapes that needed to be affected, and then I drag across to combine them like so. I also like to use the curvature tool to create perfect curves. Let's use the Shape Builder again for the backlight. To get rid of the overlapping lines like these, select them and use the Shape Builder. While holding Option key on your keyboard, you can carefully click on the line to delete it. You will see it turn red. So let's now direct our attention to the wheels. I started by creating multiple circles. I did a Command C, and then I did Command F to duplicate them, and then resized. Let's then use the Shape Builder tool to remove the overlapping shapes. I'll then add some tire threads, using the Width tool to taper off the end of it. We will want to duplicate this around the wheel, so select the Rotation tool and Option click in the center point. A box will come up. I'll give it a 12 degree angle and click on copy. And then to duplicate it around, you could do Command or Control D. In order to better organize the illustration, I will create a new set of layers for the wheels. This will allow the wheel to be behind the main body of the scooter, and it will be easier to color later on. Select the wheel area we created, except for the circle at the center, and drag it below to the wheel layer. Going back to the outline layer, let's continue tracing the Vespa's body. Now, I will bring in an image of the Vespa logo. To turn it into a vector, I quickly went to the Image Trace option and then clicked on Expand, and then placed the vector logo on the scooter. We're now done the outline, so let's add the base colors. On the color layer, I will select a bright red color from my palette, and with the pen tool, I will retrace the scooter, thus coloring it in, just like we do in a coloring book. Let's do the same for the wheel part. Now that we're done adding the base colors, let's add the shadows and the highlights. As you can see, if I turn on the template layer and close the color layers, it will reveal my sketch. I had already drawn where I'd like my shadows to be placed. So going on the shadow layer for the body and the wheels, we can just trace out the shadows using a darker toned color. Here is another way you can add shadows or highlights. I will select a color on the seat and go to the layers panel and copy it over to the shadow layer holding Option on my keyboard. Then going to the shadow layer, I will drag and duplicate another layer and move it upwards, creating a gap. Then we will bring up the shape builder tool and I'll just delete these shapes, leaving a portion behind. I'll then change that new shape to a darker tone, creating a shadow. I will add some highlights by creating circles with a lighter color. And there you have it, everyone. This is how you draw a scooter or literally anything in my style in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed it, and please let me know your thoughts in the comment sections below. Cheers, everyone.